To maintain listener interest in the story, we ran an on-air competition for a listener to go and meet them at the halfway point in Tokyo. I took the winner, Joanne Holton from Staffordshire. I won't forget the scene as Joanne and I went to the docks in Tokyo where Simon and Jonathan had just arrived, having bummed a lift on board one of those enormous container ships. Simon came rushing down the gangplank to greet us with open arms, while poor old Jonathan staggered after him, weighed down by the 90 kilos of dish. A fair distribution of labour, Simon would say. Joking apart, they did very well. They made some super radio shows, and I was very sorry for them when they came unstuck on their way back. This was because Saudi Arabia refused them permission to cross overland and insisted that they overfly that country. Nevertheless, in their 78 days away, they covered 25,000 miles through 27 countries on ships, trains, camels, cars, buses, donkeys, and trucks, and they raised £300,000 for Oxfam's Third World projects. They were pretty shattered when they arrived back to a hero's welcome. Smiley Marley and another producer, Mick Wilkowicz, had decorated the front of Broadcasting House with Welcome Home banners, something which had never been done in the history of the BBC. The roadshow vehicle was parked outside, and several hundred fans gathered to greet them. It was one of the outstanding events staged during my time at Radio 1, and I was very grateful they'd brought it to me.